recently collaborated again with Mr. Nolan. And I obviously don't want to ask you anything about your character because I don't want to have you talk about the story. I'm more fascinated by or more interested in the way Nolan directs, maybe in comparison to the way you direct. And if you could maybe sort of, are you very different in the way you guys work on set? Is it similar?
Well, I just wouldn't compare us. I can't think of myself really in the same breath, to be perfectly honest. I know that we both do the same job, but watching him is really a joy. He's an artist to his fingertips, and he's also an artisan. He values every part of the process. He has a great team. Emma Thomas is a great producer. No one should underestimate the phenomenal influence and contribution that she makes. His team of collaborators, his cinematographer, stunt director, their importance to him, continuity, a script supervisor, all these people have done, you know, numerous films with him, and he trusts them, and he lets them do their job, and he values their job. So for me, I can't see myself because I'm not outside myself to see myself enough doing it. But what I do know is that I feel that he's a consummate artist in what he does. And as I've said before, actually, he seems to be able to manipulate time. Not only does he obsess about doing it in the stories of his movies, in the making of them, he seems to stop time in order to address difficult things. I never felt, as I sometimes do in lesser hands, that you get rushed when big effects moments in movies overpower, and the crane and the action and the equipment and the vehicles are all happening, and suddenly the actors all get a bit panicked because you need to do it because it needs to happen now. Chris Nolan seems to be able to kind of stop that in a sort of Matrix pause, come and direct you as if there wasn't a care in the world. You could take all day to rehearse the scene if you want, and then go back to unleashing the monster of chaos that will surround you and making the two things marry up. And it's a great thing to see. It's like seeing someone like sort of seeing a painter at work. It's fascinating to watch. I wouldn't put myself in that category, but it's great to learn from.
I'm curious, how many takes does he like to do, and how many takes do you like to do?
In both cases, as many takes as it takes.
Oh, got it. Another thing I've always been curious about, when you're on a movie like Tenet or a big secretive movie, if you will, is it sort of, do you end up signing a piece of paper that says you will not talk about anything, some NDA, or is it sort of like people just, you just know, don't talk about certain specifics?
I feel with Christopher Nolan in a very old fashioned way, it's a handshake. I mean, it just, in both cases, I tell you how I got the script. The door knocked, I opened the door, and standing at the door was an international film director called Chris Nolan. And he had an envelope under his arm, and he said, I've come to deliver the script to you. So it doesn't get more kind of personal than that, you know. And then how will we talk about this? 24 hours from now, sir, I will give you a telephone call, and we'll discuss it. And it's as simple as that. And he says, it'd be nice if we maybe kept this to ourselves. He doesn't even say anything. I don't even say it like that, but nobody signs anything. It's a handshake and a sort of level of trust.
Do you feel a little nervous having that script in your possession due to the amount of people that want access to it or want to read it? I mean, do you know what I mean?
Yes. No, it's scary. It's a loaded thing. So when there are new scripts, I run to Chris's associate producer, Andy, who will take from me either my script or will replace the pages that are chased. But I don't ever want to have a script that isn't kind of locked in my bag. I mean, that is very, very nervous making. Like on an airplane, if you're traveling to location and you're reading it. I mean, frankly, on a Nolan film, you think about that before your passport, you know, because it'd be fine if they don't let me into Estonia. But if they do let me into Estonia and I don't have the script for Tenet, I'm done. It's over.
It's true, though. Are you amazed at the level of interest in this film, or is it sort? Have you noticed? Because everything you say, people sort of talk about.
The um, the pandemic and, you know, our movement towards this latest development in it, which might include, God please, a lessening of things that might be helped, supported, you know, symbolized by the return of large numbers of people to, albeit a distanced but still group communal experience of a piece of entertainment. That's a big deal in our world right now, isn't it? It's symbolically important. And if it would seem to go with what I can tell you it will, which is a movie that is worth the public's attention, then that could be a great thing. I know that all other movie companies are looking at it with real interest, to say the very least, because it also uniquely combines with Chris's unusual brand, an auteur filmmaker who knows how to make a blockbuster. So if he's on form, then the movie business gets a lovely kick back into the direction of somewhere near normal.